Hey, thanks for dropping comments asking about my system, motivating me to work on more videos. As you know, my YouTube channel is sporadic, as I am a Josh of all trades kind of guy, so I do everything. I've been busy with life and stuff in general.
Choir accompaniment!
E-bike building! Building and upgrading my solar panel setup! Getting addicted to speed! And distance! But I guess that's a boring old excuse. Anyway, the video is here, so enjoy! I'm trying out my new thing here. Sources are on the top right of the screen.
Oh, credits will still roll!
Just not as hard.
History!
I've been fascinated by renewable energy ever since I started building computers and running them 24/7. I was considering some types of renewable energy. Water turbine? It gets grimy. Wind? Outside weather isn't too kind. Solar comes up as the most practical, as it has no moving parts. I can keep the solar panels on the inside of the house windows to avoid adverse weather and bugs, even if it means I don't get the best power. Personally, I'm not big on sunshine anyway. I prioritize the east windows because they are the least obstructed outside. Also, the sun rises on the east. And south ones because I live in the northern hemisphere.
Anatomy of solar panel system!
And now it's time for a sing-along.
The solar panel's connected to the charge controller. Controller is connected to the battery. The battery's connected to the inverter. Here's my solar panel system. Yay.
How to begin?
Man, where do I begin?
If you are an absolute cheapskate, beginner, and want a taste to this gateway drug to the free energy, then you could get away with just a solar panel and a cigarette lighter USB charger. After all, most solar panels and car electrical systems are 12 volts. But remember, with small panels, charges small appliances. And it's only fine and dandy in perfect sunlight. Too little sunlight breaks the inverter or your device, so you have to really watch little Goldilocks here. This is where the solar charge controller comes in. It controls the energy flow better and stops the charge going backwards. In my experience, though, the solar charge controller can only fully work once the battery is connected. So, pick a battery, any battery! Speaking of batteries, there's plenty of types. I can explain thoroughly, but I'm sure there's better YouTube videos explaining these things. Lead-acid batteries are the ones found in your car. It's cheaper, but it has dangerous acid in it, needs ventilation, and can't be discharged completely without breaking it. Lithium-ion is the opposite. It's long-lasting, it's expensive, and can be discharged more fully than the deepest, cycliest lead-acid battery. There are other types and subtypes, but they aren't as common, so do your own research. Unless you want me to make another video detailing these things, in which case, like this video, subscribe to this channel, and leave a comment down below.
Oh no! I'm a YouTuber now! Oh no!
Anyway, if you want to power real appliances with real socket plug, you need an actual inverter. It's those ones that have 12-volt battery clips on one end and a household socket on the other. Inverters, like solar panels, have a wattage rating in them.
With great power comes great wattage!
With great wattages charges great appliances! And also great price. And by great, I mean big.
The system!
And now for the main part of the show. Over the years, I keep accumulating solar panels to fill up my windows. Sometimes they are on sale, sometimes I can spend extra money. I don't put my solar panels outside due to weather, insects, and theft reasons, but I probably could hook up extras and put them outside while I mow the lawn or whatever. It all started as a humble 100-watt system hooked up to a 12-volt battery. Then I kept buying more and more. The windows can host 3 panels, so it's a total of 300 watts. During those times, I can power a single gaming laptop for video calls usage, for a 1 to 3 hours maximum during a good sunny day before the system complains of low charge. Then I discovered that 150 watts panels exist, and my window can take it, albeit with some solar cells partially blocked. So, I upgraded the 3 panels, and now I have a kind of 450 watt system. In the meantime, if the sun refuses to shine, I have this brilliant idea of using a stationary bike to generate more power. I wonder why workout gyms never thought of this.
It's free real energy.
I use the dynamo from Pedal Power Generator. Not sponsored. And with a little basic woodworking, it spins the flywheel and gives power into another solar charge controller. I'm paranoid of breaking it in case I'm too powerful. But it turns out that I'm just weak. Not only this is free energy, an incentive for a nice workout sesh, I get to hone my endurance cycling skill while I get to charge my phone and text while driving. Not condoning this, by the way. Side effects are crashes, injury, paralysis, and lawsuits. Do not text while operating heavy machinery. Professional at a closed track. Do so at your own discretion. Actually, don't. It's against the law. Don't do this at home. Actually, do this at home and not on the streets. Consult your doctor and local police for more details. I find that on a relaxed to moderate ride, I can charge a phone or two, or a fan or two, but if I go at peak performance, I can power a laptop for a few seconds. So it's not really great for power efficiency overall, but more about fitness.
Upgrades!
And gloves! Over time, my solar panel system grows, so I keep mixing and moving components. In the time of writing, editing, the 3 100-watt panels are now moved upstairs, and I have 2 pairs of windows that fit them.
This just in! I added a pair of flexible 100-watt panels for a pair of skylights, so the sun does not heat up the non-AC house further.
This means it's a system with a total of 600 watts! With that kind of power, it can charge my crazy spec e-bike that I just built. On top of that, I don't even have to think twice about charging my small stuff, like phones and Bluetooth speakers. Unless, of course, the weather turns cloudy. Which, of course, it always does. Here's a graph.
Look at this graph!
My current system. Feel free to pause the video to look it over. As for how much charge it makes, well, I just go by feel. Otherwise, I get too engrossed in the technical maths. So, in summary, yes USB, yes phones, yes e-bike, no toaster or microwave. Maybe I'll get to that once I unite the systems, or have even more solar panels. But for that, I'll need wires. Lots and lots of wires. And panels. Lots and lots of panels. The factory must grow.
Miscellaneous Faxes!
I plan to convert my truck into some sort of an RV. That is, if I still use the dang thing! My upstairs solar panel system used to be a concoction placed haphazardly on the ground or table, so I built myself a shelf from a bunch of 2x8 wood planks to fit the seemingly unusable space behind the door. I found an identical space behind another identical door close to it, so this year, I'm planning to build another one and maybe host another pair of batteries. My house has these weird little windows that only fits 50-watt and 25-watt panels. Smaller panels are not worth the money, but I eventually bought a few to boost the main system. After all,
it's free real
energy!
The future is uncertain, but one thing is for sure. The factory must grow.